You're watching the Underground Studio. Welcome back. Let's get moving on with the show.
This part of the show is what we call TV show you probably would enjoy. Despite the long name, we're going to get right to it. Today we're looking at an amazing dark comedy called Breaking Bad. Take a look.
You lost your partner today. What's his name? Emilio? Emilio is going to prison. The DEA took all your money, your lab. You got nothing. Square one. But you know the business. And I know the chemistry. I'm thinking maybe you and I could partner up.
You want to cook crystal meth? You.
Great show. Look, I really like Breaking Bad. I think the concept is really good. I think the acting is just amazing. But I just don't think it's anything to bow down to. I mean, it's certainly not in the same category as Requiem for a Dream. But
I think it's a different process and it's a different environment. Like, what it is, it's a TV show made to look like a movie.
Yeah.
And I think what they've tried to go out and achieve, they've pulled off very well. They use a lot of low-key lighting, which I think is great. And you don't see that a lot in TV shows. And for the subject that's being discussed at hand, it's great. I think it fits very nicely with the concept of the show.
Yeah, but one thing I think that they do on this show is sort of like, as opposed to Requiem for a Dream, where they make your drug use look really bad and like really dark and you don't want to do it. Mm. This is one of those shows where they glorify it. I mean, it looks fantastic. It looks like the best thing to go into. And I mean, and the colours that they use, particularly when they're out in the desert, is just like so bright and so nice. I mean, and the streets, everything, every shot is just like, is gorgeous. It looks like paradise.
They do, glorify the drug industry. But, the whole emotional side of him being, diagnosed with cancer and going into it, I think you can see means for, the reason why he does it.
Yeah, yeah. No, but how good is he's the actor? I can't even think of his name. The guy Hal from Malcolm in the Middle. Yeah. He's fantastic, isn't he?
He's superb. So he's, great performance by him and the rest of the cast by that.
And as dark as the show is, it's actually quite funny in parts.
No, it's very good. I think, the difference in characters with him and his the former student that he basically teams up with that you saw in that clip there.
It's a great story.
It's great.
You should definitely recommend it.
All right, now let's move on to the learning process with Back of the Vault, the part where we take a movie and tear its poor little heart out. Today we're pulling out Battlefield Earth.
Must know he has no intention of sharing that gold with you.
What the hell are you talking about? Now what are you even doing here? You're supposed to be mining the gold.
You really think the only reason he made that recording was to have you as his patsy? Do you, Kerr? No. He has leverage over you, and it'll guarantee you never see an ounce.
How the blast do you know about those recordings, man animal?
Really is amazing, the collection of discs you can find in Terrell's personal vault.
Oh my god, truly a shocking film. The first thing that I noticed when I watched the film was the tilted camera angles.
Oh god, can we? I've never been seasick watching a movie before, but I was like about to throw up.
It's they use it to like make the viewer discomfort, but they use it in every scene.
It's ridiculous. It's like every single shot in the entire movie is like on a ridiculous slant.
Yeah. It gives the person that's in the shot this ridiculous amount of looking room as well. They don't even tighten it up with it. It's just
And sometimes you're not sure if they're like walking down a hill and then the next scene it looks like they're walking up a hill because their ankle's like changing. It's absolutely ridiculous.
Yeah, another thing I really, really disliked about this film was introducing characters. They don't introduce the characters' names until a lengthy while into the movie. Like you're watching this and you're like, oh, that's the main person, but you don't know who this person is.
Yeah, and like, it's not just this, everything about this film is just horrible. Like, it's not just the characters, it's like the actors as well. The makeup, the props, everything is just horrible.
Yeah, the makeup on the alien race, you can tell where they've put the hair plants in and stuff like
that. And they have no makeup on the neck area. You can just, oh, it's ridiculous.
And
what about the tainted colour? Like, every second, like, scene is tainted with this. It's the most horrible colours ever. And I don't know why they've done that, but it's just disgusting.
Yeah, it's truly a shocking film.
Horrible. Anyways, it's time to get a bit practical now. Being media students ourselves, we know it's not always easy to fully realise your visions on a low budget. We're going to try to help you out by showing you how to make cheap equipment that does you wonders. Let's head over to the workbench.
All right, today we're going to be putting together our very own boom pole and shock mount. Okay, the supplies you're going to need for this are a can of food, preferably empty, okay?
Of course.
You don't want the food still in there. Hair elastics, preferably without the metal bits on the end. Usually get some metal bits like around here. You don't want them.
Thank you.
Thumbtacks, as we have there. A long pole, it can be either wood or metal. We've got two here. There's one there and one on the table as well. Duct tape or gaffer tape. There's some duct tape. Some pliers that we've got here. And a can opener.
Okay, so basically this is what the finished product is eventually going to look like. You're going to get something like this. So what we do is we basically start with our metal can, with our tin can. Basically have both ends cut out like so. So it should look something like this. After that, we take our thumbtacks and we place them about 1 to 2 centimetres from the edge of the can, equally around both sides. So it should look something like this.
You can see the finished product of what he's just talking about there. So evenly spaced all around the can. You can put some sticky tape around there as well so the thumbtacks don't fall out. All right, there's the inside. After we've done that, what we do is we grab our pliers and we bend the inside there to about a 45 degree angle. Like that. Then what we do is we get our hair tie, push it down over like that, grab our pliers again, and put it like that so it stays attached to the edge of the wall.
Okay, so you're going to end up with something that looks similar to this. So basically you have your elastics on both sides of the can and you're going to get this nice hole in the middle to fit your mic in. So the next step, what we're going to do is actually tape this to the pole. So you have your pole. You just want to grab that. And you basically tape it to the very end.
Like that. So you just tape it round like this, all the way around like that.
Okay, great. So what have we got in the end, Morgan?
So we've got this. This is the boom pole. So just showing you again, we put the mic through like that and out the other side. Just like that.
Very well done, Morgan. There you go. Homemade boom pole. Well, that's about all we have time for today. I hope you enjoyed looking at the movies, both good and bad, and tossing together a new boom mic. Thanks for joining us.
Sam here, good luck in your future projects, and we'll catch you here at the Underground Studio. Good night.